Hello， 大家好，呢度系实拍实说嘅钟先生。我哋今日咧嚟咗 John Paul 啦 International College， 咁啊，我哋一齐去参观呢间学校。咁大家跟我嚟啦。呢度嘅系主要嘅 reception 啦。咁啊喺呢度咧就会摆住咧就好多嗰啲啊喺旧学生啦，好成功噶啦。特別係咧，就係話有幾個咧就有好出名啦，好似嗰啲 professor 咁樣啦，喺大學做緊 professor 啦，教緊書啦，教醫學院嘅有，教啊教個商科嗰啲有，或者係嗰個 taxation 嗰啲都有啦。跟住咧就啊喺呢度咧又有奧林匹克運動員啦嚇，即係話係攞冠軍嘅運動員啦，都係呢間學校畢業嘅。咁啊嚇呢個係2021年嘅冠軍咧，金牌。都是这间的旧学生咯。John Paul 入面咧都有啲嗰个室外嘅嗰个娱乐设施啦，因为咧呢度有小学啊，同埋中学嘅学生。所以咧係睇得到咧，就有啲嚇叫做啊嚇啊 outdoor 嘅 space 啦，俾學生去玩嘅。John Paul 咧嗰個 technology 嘅運用咧，係去到好細個咧就可以令到個學生咧好熟悉個運用。佢哋利用呢個 high technology 咧，就去管理個學生嘅嗰個學習同埋成長。簡單嚟講咧，佢每一個學生咧都有個 ID， 咁你喺呢度咧就篤一下，咁咧就係話 key 入你嘅密碼，你個 學生嘅密碼咧，咁你 scan 個嘢咧就直接即係入到你嘅嗰個私人嘅電腦。你哋可以睇得到咧，每一個從 Year 3開始咧，每一個學生咧都有自己嘅電腦，咁啊啲電腦咧就已經係包埋嗰個學費入邊噶啦。咁啊呢度咧就係每一個學生咧都有一個名，就喺佢哋 charge 嗰啲電腦。呢個電腦咧 ，Year 3嘅人咧 ，Year 3嘅學生咧就唔可以帶翻屋企嘅。咁啊嚇 ，Year 4開始就可以帶翻屋企。咁啊佢嗰個電腦入邊咧，學校咧就係個軟件方面嘅處理得非常之好。比如話咧，佢屋企人咧，即係比如話係限制佢嚇係幾多誒咩時間可以上網，咩時間咧就係嚇斷咗嗰個網咧。咁咧就係佢可以設定咗之後咧，咁啊佢自動咧就會斷網噶啦。意思即係話咧，學生咧就唔可以喺嗰段時間咧就係話上網，但係咧佢一樣可以做佢個功課嘅。呢個嚇，同埋咧就係話個軟件方面咧，佢都有嚇直接咧就係同嗰個網絡咧聯繫，即係話係監督學生睇嗰個上網啦。如果係睇一啲即係話係唔適合細路仔嗰啲嚇。網咧，佢哋又係可以即刻咧去到嗰個 central 嘅嗰個控制嗰度咧，係提醒，咁咧跟住咧就可以即係 block 咗佢咯。嚇，呢啲台咧就睇落咧，你睇到唔同嘅嚇，呢啲台係好特別嘅，因為呢啲台咧你寫嘢喺嗰度咧，佢哋咧就係用嗰個 technology 咧就 scan 咗之後咧，就直接上咗個電腦方面噶啦。咁咧即係意思即係話咧，佢喺學生佢哋喺可以喺嗰個台度嗰度寫嘢。呢度你係睇得到咧，就係話好唔同嘅地方咧。佢哋每一個即係呢個係 Year 4嘅課室啦。咁你睇到嗰個台咧係有高有低嘅。咁你就根據佢哋係學嘢嗰陣時用咩嘅地方啦。咁你就喺呢個台嗰度寫嘢。咁你就去 scan 咗之後咧，就直上咗嗰個電腦入邊，喺佢哋嘅私人嘅電腦入邊咧已經有呢個記錄啦。 呢度咧就係張波嘅餐廳啦，個 touch shop 啦。咁呢度咧即係話係，就算一個餐廳咧，佢哋都用咗 technology 咧去嗰個管理嘅。咁如果係學生咧，如果係要喺呢度食飯咧，嗰、那個學生卡入邊咧就可以儲蓄嘅。意思咧即係阿爸阿媽咧喺香港咧，就將啲錢咧經過嗰個 online 咧，就係擺喺嗰個卡入邊。擺咗個卡入邊咧，佢喺呢度可以食嘢咯。呢、這個餐廳咧就係、是、其實都係利用緊即係話大數據咁樣去管理嘅。比如話咧，就係話係食佢哋即係因為佢每一日嘅食嘢咧都唔會相同嘅。即係意思咧就係不斷去改啦。比如話係今日係亞洲餐啦，聽日係西餐啦，又墨西哥餐啦，或者係話係又食 pizza 啦。但係如果係話係嗰啲食物咧，如果係話係唔即係話銷售得唔好。咁咧，即係意思，即係話咧，就係學生唔係咁中意。如果係銷售得好咧，即係意思話係好多人中意食咧。佢哋咧，即係話咧，佢哋喺呢方面嘅管理咧，去迎合到嗰啲學生嘅口味咯。呢個係一個特別嘅管理嘅方法啦。咁另外一個咧，就係話係，如果係個住 homestay 嘅家長咧，如果佢嚟唔切煮嘢俾嗰啲學生食，佢喺喺 online 嗰度 order 咧，佢喺呢度咧就可以攞食物啦。意思咧，即係話 homestay 冇時間煮嗰啲嘢，佢可以 order 喺呢度，呢度學生就喺呢度咧，就根據嗰個 ID 咧，咁啊就喺呢度攞佢食物。所以咧就係話係全方位嘅嗰個資訊管理咯。呢度咧就係張坡嘅嗰個泳池啦，可以睇得到啦。雖然今日係假期啦，咁啊學生咧都可以自己過嚟呢度遊嘅，游水。同埋咧隔離咧就係話係嗰個室內運動場啦，你可以入嚟睇得到。呢啲雖然係放假，學生喺呢度打波啦，打排球啦。喺呢度咧就係喺John Paul嘅嗰個 gym room 入邊啦嚇 ，gymnasium 啦。咁咧就咁啱咧就見到國內學生阿 Jack， 哈哈。阿 Jack 你來了多久啦？
我來了兩年了。
兩年啦、啊。對這感覺怎麼樣？這所學校對你這感覺？
這個學校。对我来说改变挺大的，
为什么呢？
就刚开始来的时候呢，就不喜欢运动，
不喜欢运动，
对，然后呢也比较内向嘛。
哦、okay ，
然后来了之后呢，就经常过来运动，和老师同学们一起，就人也变得比较外向。
OK， 就是已经是自己的个性方面有已经是有一定的改变。
对，
哦，那得很重要啊，啊，因为呢你要以后进入社会的时候，你必须要是外向型。
嗯，
对对对。
对，
那么呢，在这里多了两年，习惯吗？
还蛮习惯的，
蛮习惯的。
对。
吃啊住啊还有呢这里的同学啊友善吗？
都同学都很友善，
就
自己吧，自己的因素比较大、
okay.
自己友善一点，别人也友善。
OK， 你为什么选择这所学校呢？
当初是父母推荐的
啊。父母推荐？
对、
okay.
同的父母的朋友推荐过来的。
哦，父母的朋友推荐的。
对，
因为对这个学校有一定的了解。
对，因为这边华人也比较多、
okay.
然后呢也是附近非常好的一所学校。
OK， 非常好，因为比较方便是吗？你居住在什么地方？你居住在 homestay？
我住在 homestay。
homestay 是外国家庭吗？
是外国家庭。
哦，那饮食啊，还有呢，就是各方面习惯吗？
饮食都很习惯的。那个外国人跟我父母也有些时候有点交流，所以会改善一下伙食。
哦、对对，你在你读书这一段时间，你父母有来探访你吗？
没有，就疫情嘛。
OK， 有疫情。OK 哈，那么你也打算继续在这里读下去，而且呢，就是大学也在。大学选择在澳大利亚读吗？
大学应该在澳大利亚上。
OK 哈、
My name is David Ferguson. I'm Deputy Head of International Operations at John Paul College. So what that means is I look after international students in our ELICOS program, so our English language program, but also international students from primary to secondary school. I think studying in Australia for many students from different countries is a very different experience. For example, I went to school in the UK, and even from the UK to Australia, the schooling is very different. So your classrooms are, you have to walk outside to get to your classrooms. You're not just in one building. The space of the campus, so to walk from one end of our campus to the other, would take you about 15 minutes. So there's a lot of walking to do. So that's kind of the geographical difference. I think the biggest difference, and students are usually aware of this, but the biggest difference is the pedagogy, so the science of teaching and learning in Australia to perhaps some other countries overseas. It's not chalk and talk. We require absolute engagement from our students, and you know, as a teacher myself, I'm very interested to understand the opinions and perspectives and why students have that, and that critical thinking to, you know, to solve problems like this. And so it's that evaluative and analytical thinking. The Australian education system is very well known around the world, and each state in Australia is in charge of its own education system. So in Queensland, we have the Queensland Certificate of Education, which is recognised worldwide, and from that you get a tertiary rank for universities worldwide as well. The Australian education system is from 7 to 10 is controlled by the federal government, so students learn the same curriculum, and that's very, very broad. But then it allows you to go into depth of each subject. So the idea is not to have a superficial knowledge of the subject, but to have an in-depth knowledge. So at John Paul College, from year 7 to 9, we have STEM electives, where students can choose, for example, to have a look at robotics in depth, or you know, drones, or 3D printing and design in depth. So whether when they get to year 10, they can decide what to do for their Queensland Certificate of Education in year 11 and 12, which is Form 5 and 6. That's something that we do really well. So it's about the future employability. And the jobs that we don't know exist yet, but we want students to have agile skills to be ready for those jobs. We have John Paul International College, and we've been open since 1997. And so we're kind of a trailblazer, first mover in this space. And so we have high school preparation for years, you know, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and primary preparation for students going to year 4, 5, and 6. And so it's our strong belief that students need to be set up with adequate English ability for them to be able to achieve success. We don't just throw them in the back of a classroom and say, good luck. We have a separate ELICOS program where we teach English and maths to make sure that they're ready for success in the main school. So I'm proud to work in an international office with five other colleagues. And so our job is to only look after international students, so international students can feel well supported. And most of our international students move into homestay accommodation. Now that's moving from a type of residential living perhaps in their home country to a very different suburban living here, with, you know, a large house and a garden, and you know, it might be similar, but for a lot of our students it's not. And then also the public transport is different here, so things aren't as convenient, so therefore things are a little bit more laid back, and that can cause a bit of a culture shock for our students. But as I said, we have an international office, and we're very experienced in dealing with students that are experiencing that culture shock, and they usually come out of it pretty quickly. I understand for parents it's a difficult decision, because if you send your child away at 14, you know, that's quite young. At 15, when they get to 16, 17, you know, it's easier for parents to do that. But from an education standpoint, and the data that I look at, students arriving in you know, year 9 or year 8 or year 7 are really, really, really used to the college. They're assimilated into the college by the time they get to year 10 and 11.
Yes.
So really the sweet spot for me is to make sure that you're here by year 9. Okay. Now, if students arrive later, that's still possible.
Yeah.
But the year 9 gives them the time to settle in and get used to things in a not as critical point in their education.